In sports today, the Raptors will be looking pretty old school tonight. Here's Rob Williamson with the details and the rest of your sports news.
Thank you very much, Natalie. We'll kick things off in sports today with a look at last night's Leafs game. The Toronto Maple Leafs were taking on Eric Staal and the Minnesota Wild last night at the ACC, looking for their first win against the Wild in over 3 years. And in the first, they got off to a bit of a rough start. Nazem Kadri mishandles the puck and gets pinned behind his own net, and the puck bounces out in front and onto Jason Zucker's stick. All he needs to do is slot it over the right shoulder of Anderson, and Minnesota is up one early. The first wouldn't get any better for the Buds, though. Justin Spurgeon, he finds Chris Stewart on the breakout, and Chris Stewart turns on those jets and just slips it between Freddie Anderson's pads. The Wild with the 2-0 look early in the first. Nearing the end of the frame, Leafs playing from center ice. Kadri, he walks in and lays one on net, but Benny Smith is there to tuck in the rebound. That would be Benny's second of the season, and that puts the Leafs to within one. Though, early in the second we go, after a scrum in the corner, the puck finds Eric Staal from behind the net, and he slots it. He slots the backhander behind Anderson to make it 3-1. And check Tyler Bozak on the replay. He gets caught puck watching and lets Staal dance his way to the slot. But down on the other end, Bozak redeems himself. He absolutely undresses Matt Dumba and flips in his sixth of the season off the backhand. Gives Dumba a little dancing lesson and brings Toronto to within one. Whew, look at that little dipsy doodle. But in the third, with the extra attacker out there, the Leafs got one more good look on net. And Devan Dubnyk shuts the door, holding on to the 3-2 lead as the Wild beat the Leafs for the seventh game in a row. And more news out of the NHL. The Vegas Golden Knights had their expansion plans put on hold last night. The Vegas Golden Knights have hit a bump in the road on their way to becoming the NHL's newest expansion team. Last night, the United States Patent and Trademark Office denied the team's Golden Knight branding. The USPTO has cited the likelihood of confusion with the NCAA St. Rose Golden Knights as the reason for denial. The team will move to overturn the ruling, and league officials are confident that Vegas' NHL team will remain the Golden Knights. In hardwood news, the Raps will be sporting some throwback jerseys during tonight's game with the Minnesota Timberwolves. DeMar DeRozan, Kyle Lowry, and the rest of your Toronto Raptors are facing a visit from Thornhill native Andrew Wiggins, two-time dunk champion Zach LaVine, and the 2016 Rookie of the Year, Karl-Anthony Towns. Both the court and the Raps will be sporting throwback looks, honoring the old Toronto Huskies NBA team. The Huskies playing in the first ever NBA game against the New York Knicks back in 1946, but were disbanded after compiling a 22-38 record in their first season. The Raps are sitting at second in the East after coming off a 4-point loss to the conference-leading Cleveland Cavaliers. Tip-off is at 7 o'clock. And that's all we have for sports. Now with a look at what Mother Nature has in store, here's Helena Schlappback.
Thanks, Rob. Well, I probably should have invested in some gloves because it's freezing out here and the wind's not helping. Today, we're looking at mainly cloudy skies with a high of 0 and a 30% chance of flurries. While we're all snuggled in our beds, the temperature will dip to a low of minus 6 with a 40% chance of flurries. Friday morning, we're looking at a high of minus 1 with overcast skies and a 40% chance of flurries. And if you're hitting the club on Friday, prepare to get low with the temperature as we're dipping to minus 8 with a 30% chance of flurries. Saturday's looking a little colder with a high of minus 3, a mix of sun and clouds, and a 30% chance of flurries. Our nighttime low will be minus 7 with 30% chance of snow. Well, it looks like the sun won't be making much of an appearance in the next couple of days. But if you have no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Now back to Natalie in the warm newsroom.
We leave you with this fun video. People aren't the only ones getting jolly for the season. Check out these penguins all dressed up in their holiday outfits. Just like us, the penguins were dressed in Santa Claus outfits, Christmas tree vests, and woolly jackets. But hey, looks like they forgot the ugly Christmas sweaters. That's all for today. For details of these stories and more, check out humbernews.ca. Humber News is written and produced by students in the journalism program at the North Campus. Our technical crew are students from the broadcast television and videography program. I'm Natalie Dixon. Join us tomorrow for our next news update.